Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I am your host, Susan Jo Philip, and these are the major news stories of the day. First is an update on the controversial movie, The Kerala Story. The Supreme Court on Thursday refused to entertain a plea challenging the release of the film. Hurt by the behavior of the Delhi police, who allegedly manhandled them on Wednesday night, the protesting wrestlers have threatened to return their medals and awards to the government. Patna High Court has stayed the Bihar government's decision to conduct a caste-based census. 9,000 people shifted to safer places in violence-hit Manipur, and several columns of army deployed to contain rioting. And last, a 13-year-old boy gunned down 8 fellow pupils and security guard in a Serbian school. Let's get into the details. The Supreme Court on Thursday refused to entertain a petition challenging the CBFC certification granted to the controversial movie The Kerala Story, written and directed by Sudeep Polsen. A bench headed by Chief Justice D.Y. Chandrachud said the Central Board of Film Certification has already certified the film, which is slated for release on May 5th. You must think of the actors, producer. They have all put in their labor. You must be very careful about staying films. The market will decide if it is not up to the mark. We are not inclined. The bench, also comprising Justices P.S. Narasimha and J.B. Paddiwala, said. The film is based on the alleged radicalization and conversion of young Hindu women to Islam in Kerala before inducting them into terrorist outfit Islamic State. Hurt by the boorish behavior of the Delhi police, the protesting wrestlers on Thursday threatened to return their medals and awards, including the Padma Shri, to the government, saying these honors serve no purpose if they have to endure such humiliation. Around 11 p.m. on Wednesday, a scuffle broke out when the wrestlers were bringing in folded beds for sleeping, and the on-duty police personnel began inquiring about that, as rules do not permit bringing in such things at the protest site. Vinesh Bhogat and Sakshi Malik claimed that they were abused and pushed by male police officers, leaving them in tears. Two wrestlers, including Sankita Bhogat's brother Dushyant, suffered injuries. If this is how the wrestlers will be treated, what will we do with the medals? Rather, we will live an ordinary life and return all the medals and awards to the Indian government, Bajrang, an Olympic bronze medalist, said. Patna High Court on Thursday, in an interim order, stayed the Bihar government's decision to conduct a caste-based census. The bench of Chief Justice K. Vinod Chandran and Justice Mudresh Prasad gave its verdict after hearing the three pleas filed before it, including the one filed by the NGO Youth for Equality. The matter would be heard next on July 3rd. The decision came 6 days after the Supreme Court asked the High Court to consider, decide and dispose of the interim application of Youth for Equality, preferably within 3 days. The Bihar government launched the caste survey on January 7. The plan was to compile data on each family digitally through the mobile application in the survey from the panchayat to the district level. Several columns of the army and Assam rifles had to be hurriedly deployed overnight to contain large-scale rioting that broke out across Manipur between tribals and the majority Maiti community, displacing over 9,000 people. Clashes broke out on Wednesday, which intensified overnight, with counter-attacks being mounted by rival communities in retaliation to earlier attacks after Naga and Kuki tribals organized a tribal solidarity march. So far, 9,000 people were rescued by the forces from the violence-hit areas and given shelter, a defense spokesperson said on Thursday, adding that more people are being shifted to safer places. Meanwhile, the Congress alleged that Manipur was burning because the BJP has created fissures among communities with its politics of hate. A 13-year-old boy gunned down 8 fellow pupils and a security guard in a Belgrade school on Wednesday in a planned attack, prompting Serbia's president to announce tighter curbs on gun ownership. Using 2 handguns that belonged to his father, the boy fired first at the guard and 3 girls in a hallway and then shot his teacher and classmates in a history lesson, police said. The teacher and 6 pupils were hospitalized, some with life-threatening injuries. As Serbia prepared for 3 days of national mourning, President Aleksandar Vučić announced a moratorium on new gun licenses other than for hunting, revision of existing permits and surveillance of shooting ranges and how civilians store their weapons. And that brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose hosted by me, Susan Jo Philip. Daily News Dose podcast is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow on Manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.